Welcome back to The Rhode Show and this Beach Week. This morning in The Buzz, we are wrapping up Beach Week, and yes, like we do all the time. Is this any shock to anybody? We're talking food.
All right.
All right. Sure, it is easy to fire up that grill and throw on some steaks or hot dogs in the summer. I love those. Who wants to preheat the oven on a 90-degree day like it's going to be really warm this weekend? So we wanted to know, what are some of your favorite summertime meals, and what about the food you're bringing to the beach? Now, Nick Raybar was here, and he made just some great stuff to bring to the beach.
Yeah,
not just to the beach, but all around.
If you missed it, he made the almost like side salads. You don't even have to have them on the side. I would eat them just alone.
Sure.
It was, you know, tomatoes and, you know, beans, couscous, whatever it was. So we made a whole variety there, but that's what I like.
Right.
Fresh, crisp,
yeah.
And I love, like, stuff that's cold,
cold
at the beach. So really cold grapes,
mm-hmm.
or cold watermelon.
Right.
I don't know. I think when I'm sitting out in the sun, I want like that cold, refreshing, also, you know, light food. I don't want anything that's going to sit too heavy, because then I feel...
You feel.
I just feel kind of gross.
Right.
You're sitting in the heat. You got nowhere else to go. No one really wants to sit there with, you know, eggplant parmesan and going to town on it.
I need a steak knife.
Not that there's anything wrong with eggplant parmesan, but you know what I mean. That's not beach food to me. It's like, you know, cold, refreshing fruit. And even as a kid, I remember making Kool-Aid. But do you remember those jugs that were like,
Kool-Aid.
You know, red on the bottom, the top screwed on, and
little
had the little spout that came up?
Right.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
That's how we would have
They would always leak. They would always leak.
They would always leak.
The seal on the inside was just garbage, and it would always leak. I don't know why. You'd be pouring it this way, and stuff would be coming up this way.
Yeah. You'd go into the cup, fine, but then you're right, out of the side.
And it always leaked. Yeah, you had to get that cap on. Just
pour it over the sand.
Right, just the right way. Just the right way. For me, if I'm home, I've got one of these, like the Weber charcoal grills, which I love.
Oh,
if you're not cooking with the charcoal grill,
delicious.
You got to do that. And I will take a chicken, almost like John and Joe did yesterday, and put like a whole chicken on there early in the morning, put it on one side, fire up the charcoal, and also take like some wood chips and throw it in.
Yep.
Like apple or something like that. Mm. Put that in. Let it sit there all day long. And then you take the cover off. It's like, you know, one of these things. And you take that chicken apart, and you can save it. Even if you're not going to eat it that day, put it in salad, put it in something during the week.
Mm-hmm.
Tastes fantastic.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. There. All those grilled items in the summertime, vegetables, meats, whatever
all
it is.
All good.
Yes. I love it.
Now we said it all.
We did. All right. But not quite everything, because we want to take a look at what our Facebook friends are saying. Jean Wiley Sadler gives us a recipe from her childhood. Get your pens and paper ready.
All right.
She writes, my mom made what she called radio sandwiches.
What
I love
this
because she heard the recipe on the radio. They are made with cream cheese, walnuts, pimento stuffed olives mixed in mayo and spread on bread. Sounds weird, huh? But they were delicious.
I think it sounds pretty good.
Ada Branco and I enjoy similar beach meals. She says, I usually take some fruit to the beach, light and easy.
Mm-hmm.
Patricia Adelio Estrella loves any type of salad. The more colorful, the better. I love salads, too.